builder got the building permits approved this Monday, and they started work and they've had a lot of progress done. And I'm gonna go ahead and show you that progress.
For those of you who have started with us at the beginning of this journey, you'll remember that the culvert was laying in the grass. They have now installed it, and it looks like it's been a casualty of being ran over. So we'll have to fix that. Here's the start of the driveway, and I'm so glad that is installed because it's really nice getting in here now with the rock in instead of it being narrow and dirt. Our driveway is over 900 feet long. We still have to have the gas company come out and install the gas line. We're gonna head on over to the splice pit. I'll show you that because it looks like it's changed a little bit. And ComEd also did come out and take a look at it. Then we'll head over to where the house is going to be. The builder already started digging, and so you'll get to see that. The driveway contractor had stopped by and put stakes in before the driveway was done, and we moved those stakes over a little bit, and so I'm really glad to see that they followed our instruction, and I think that they've done a great job so far, so I'm really looking forward to when the driveway gets finished later on. Right here is where the splice pit is. ComEd did come out and they checked it, made sure my husband did a good job, and I think he did because they didn't say anything about it, but they did put a stake in there and marked it with the ComEd flag. It looks like it has been caved in a little bit, so ComEd will have to dig that out in order to get to the pipe so they can cut through it in order to connect the two cables. Now we're gonna head over to the house, and you'll see the progress that's been done in 5 days. It's really amazing how fast the builder is moving. It did take 3 months to get the building permit approved. So I think they're trying to make up for that, and we really appreciate them. It looks a little bit messy, but why wouldn't it be that way? It is a building site. So the builder has gotten the basement dug out, and they have started putting in the footings, which is great. We're gonna have some dry days ahead of us, and it's perfect timing. And then right behind me is where the stairway is gonna go in. We're hoping to put a pole barn right over here, so when we need to bring things into the basement, they can go right through a door and go right down the stairwell that's gonna be in the garage, and then straight down to the basement. So we think that'll be really nice. This portion here is going to be where the garage will be, and then this is facing the front entry of the house. And because it sounds fun, let's go ahead and head down into where the basement's going to be. So this is gonna be where the living room would be above the basement, the front entryway, and then we're facing the stairway, and then over onto the right is gonna be 2 bedrooms. And then in the back left corner is where the master bathroom will be.
and then there will be a walk-in closet, and then the master bedroom, and then this far corner is going to be a seasons room. And then the kitchen will be somewhat right where I'm at. And we're back into the living room.
So it actually looks like the builder got in all the footings. So I'm pretty excited to see where they get next week before winter starts heading in. And so I brought you over here to the rough-in for the electric. Luke did all of this, and there was an electric inspection, and on the first inspection it passed. And then ComEd also came by and they put in their flag and took a look at it, and we haven't heard from them, so it must be good. And so last time we had a stake with a sock on it, but now we have both piping coming out for the transformer, so that is ready to go. We've been looking at these dirt piles that they dug up, and we're finding some nice rocks here that we could use to build up the creek bank, and we've been doing that. It's a nice rock, Daddy. And here's another nice one.
We have been finding piles of rocks all throughout the property. We think it's probably the farmer moving them over. So we've been compiling those rocks and taking them down to the creek so that way we can put them on the banks. There's a couple reasons why we are compiling these rocks and putting them on the banks. The first is we're hoping that it strengthens the banks from washing out. It looks like over the years the banks have been washing away. The second is because, of course, it looks aesthetically nice. There's other ways we could use these rocks. We could line the driveway with them. We can do landscaping with them. We even thought of using them for the fireplace that will be in the living room. But ultimately, we decided that the creek banks needed to be focused on first, and then any extras we'll go ahead and use towards those other things.
Well, family and friends, that concludes today's update. Thank you for joining our Littlewoods Homestead. I hope you have a wonderful day.